Welcome to USMLEFasttrack.com. The section we're going to talk about today is from
First Aid for the USMLE Step 1, 2013 edition.
Page 349. Platelet plug formation. What is the first step in platelet plug formation? The first step is the injury step. What happens in the injury step of platelet plug formation? In the injury step, what happens is the endothelium is damaged. There is a cut on the endothelium, which will expose its collagen. When that collagen is exposed, one Willebrand factor will bind to the exposed collagen. What is the second step of platelet plug formation? The second step in platelet plug formation is the adhesion and activation step. What happens in the adhesion step? In the adhesion step, what happens is now the platelets will need to bind to that one Willebrand factor. So the platelet comes along and binds to the 1 Willebrand factor via its GP1 receptor at the site of injury. Once the platelet has bound to 1 Willebrand factor, it will release ADP and calcium, and this is necessary for coagulation cascade to start. This ADP that has been released will activate platelets and will help platelets adhere to endothelium. ADP will then bind to receptors and cause glycoprotein 2B and 3A to be expressed on the platelet surface. What is the third step of platelet plug formation? The third step of platelet plug formation is the aggregation step. Describe what happens in the aggregation step of platelet plug formation. In the aggregation step, what happens is fibrinogen comes along and binds to glycoprotein 2B and 3A receptor. And when fibrinogen comes and binds to this area, it allows the linkage of platelets to occur. And eventually, in this way, platelet plug is formed. What are the factors that modulate platelet plug formation? The factors that modulate platelet plug formation are pro-aggregation factors and anti-aggregation factors. And both of these factors are working at the same time. They are opposite forces, but both are important because their harmony is going to decide what size the clot is going to be based on the type of injury. Describe the pro-aggregation factors. Pro-aggregation factors are what are released by platelets. They release thromboxane A2, and this decreases blood flow and increase in platelet aggregation. Describe the anti-aggregation factors. Anti-aggregation factors are released by endothelial cells, and they release prostaglandin I2 and nitric oxide, and this leads to increase in blood flow and decrease in platelet aggregation. And the reason this is important is to wash away the clot, because if the clot is getting too big in size, this will wash away some of that clot to make it just of the right size. So this is how a temporary platelet plug will stop bleeding.
For more information on this topic, click on the link in the description section below. For a full USMLE Step 1 review, be sure to check us out at usmlefasttrack.com, where we help you review the entire first aid for the USMLE Step 1 with high quality videos and hundreds of detailed pictures for a better understanding of the material. So to learn from the best USMLE review book, be sure to check us out at usmlefasttrack.com.